Magandang gabi sa inyo mga kapugo. Dito na naman pong muli ako sa inyong harapan ng camera. Sana hindi kayo magsawa sa akong pagmumuka. Balita ko lang. Yung unang pasok ko sa January 7, ang weight ko nun is 72 kilograms. Ngayon, sa loob ng isang linggo, sa 1 month and 3 weeks, nabawasan ako ng 1 kilo dahil sa kapuyat sa pagpapalago ng aking channel, pangista, pagpasok sa LS, at kung anik-anik pa, pagpupuyat. Pero, anyway, mayroon naman po akong susunod na bagong video sa aking tutorial. Abangan nyo lang po. Ito yung kadugtong ng aking ginawa, yung MEP repeat tutorial number 3, ngayon number 4 na. By the way, bago ako mag-umbisa ng video, papakita ko muli sa inyo ang aking ulam! Tara! Garan! Ang ulam ko ay ito. Ganyan pa rin, chicken. Pero ito, tempeh. Tempeh sa Indonesia. Yan ang aking ulam ngayon. Para lang bukas. Para lang bukas. Para lang yung gabi. Pero bukas, putas lang ako. Okay, masarap bang tignan? Ano to yung alacham, chicken alacham. Ilagyan ko lang ng sauce. Okay na yan, pwede na yan. Ako lang naman kakain. Okay? Okay, hindi pala ako magsasabi uli ng bye-bye o kung ano man. Dahil yung bye-bye ng aking video ay nasa kasunod ng aking video. Doon. At doon sa uli ang bye-bye. At sana tulungan niyo pa rin ako kahit ang aking content ay kakaiba. Hindi nyo man maintindihan, pwili kong intindihin kasi ganun ang kaibigan. Kahit anuman, andyan pa rin sila. Di ba? Okay. So, let's go! Magandang gabing muli sa inyo mga kapugo. Andito na naman pong muli ako sa inyong harapan, ang inyong lingkod, si Poging Pugo. Ngayong gabi ay ang ating continuation ng ating tutorial. Sa this time, my tutorial is tutorial number 4, which is creating the different types of ducting elbows. Using mitered elbows, radius elbows, radius plans elbows. If you want to check my previous vlog about the coloring of the ducting, you can browse my channel and look for the vlog 58. Okay? Let's start. Okay. Ducting fittings is very important for HVAC system because this is the fittings to connect all the ductings. Okay. In the ducting, we have mitered elbows, radius elbows, and radius plans elbows. Okay. First is we will do the mitered elbows. So under the families, this one is the families. You know already what's the meaning of the families. So from the families, looking for the ducts, and then the rectangular duct, and then you can see the we have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different types of elbows. So now this time we will create the mitered elbows. Okay, just click the mitered elbows. Do not rename it, huh? Do not rename it. Just do right click and duplicate, and then change the name into rectangular mitered. Okay. After we create the
rectangular ducting using the mitered elbows. Next step is right click again, type properties and check the routing preference. This is very important. So from edit, so elbow, we will be using the single thickness, and then for the junction top, choose the rectangular takeoff. For the transition, choose the length, and the multi-shape transition rectangular to round, choose the round to rectangular transition length standard, and then in the rectangular to oval, use the length standard. Okay, after that, okay. After we create the ducting for the using the mitered elbows, you can create the ducting. Okay, from the keyboard, just type DT. DT is a shortcut to ducting. DT, and then DT, and pick here. Zoom in. Pick here, and then pick here. Okay. Since this one is different elbows, again I redo again. Okay, one more. So type DT. After you type the ducting, in the properties, scroll down, choose the rectangular mitered here. This is the correct one. So from here, pick here, pick here. So this is the mitered elbows, as you can see in the our sample of PDF, in the PDF files. So in order to connect this ducting to the going to the left, okay, just click the ducting, type CS, stands for create instance CS, pick here, and then here. So already connected the ducting to ducting with fittings. Okay, this is not the mitered. Next is the using radius elbows here. So using radius elbows, okay, from the rectangular duct again back to the families, and then choose the rectangular radius elbows top mill. Just right click, duplicate. Become 2, 3, 4 already. Okay, never mind. From after duplicate the radius elbow stops, rename it into rectangular duct. Okay, after that, again right click, type properties, and then the routing preferences, check, edit. And then we will set the elbow from 1.5 width to 1 width. Okay. And then for the junction, choose the bevel standard. And then again, transition, always check the, always choose the length. And always choose the length. Okay, I think okay already. See, rectangular duct. Okay, again type DT. Was it create the new dot. Always look for the properties and select the dot here. From here, pick. Okay, and then connect again from here. From here, and then you can right click, create similar. Correction, guys. Before I mentioned create instance. No, it should be. So create similar, click the dot thing, right click, and then create similar, pick the midpoint, and then okay, already with the fittings, different type of the fittings here. Okay, and then next is the, what is the next, radius plans elbow, using plans elbow. Okay, so again, from the radius tab here, right click, duplicate, and rename it to rectangular. Radio plans. Okay. After that, same process. Right click, type properties, and then under the fittings routing preferences, edit again. This is very important to set up your routing fittings for the different kinds of fittings. Okay, since we are using the plans, from here, use the rectangular medium radius band plans. Okay, and for the junction, scroll down and use the shoe brands here, plans, and then standard 45 degrees. Always choose the leg standard. Okay, leg standard. Okay, that's it. Okay, and now create again the new ducting by typing in the keyboard DT. After you creating the new ducting, go to the properties and scroll down, look for the rectangular plans. This is the type of ducting we created under the families. Plans again, pick here, pick here, pick here, and then right pick the ducting, right click, create similar, and then see, this is now with the plans. This is the plans from here. This is the plans. But in the inside, nothing. Usually, this drawing in the normally in the actual installation, they in the ducting, they using this kinds of ducting. But in the drawing, in the model, we can use either with a bevel type or takeoff, M rectangular takeoff. Okay, so this is the three types of the ducting we created. We do this one first because in my next video we will do the ducting. We cannot go direct to ducting layout like this in the plan, see, without knowing the elbows, how to set up the fittings of the each of every duct. So this is the very short and very simple topics, easy to follow. If you cannot follow the step, you can download and then rewind the what you call this, the video, or you can rewind or fast forward. So this is, these are the types of the ducting fittings. I will not what you call this, elaborate more, because our topic is only for the ducting. Okay guys, this is the very short tutorial, but very important. You must know what are the correct fittings of its every ducting. By the way guys, again muli ako ay humihingi uli ng suporta, although ang aking mga subscriber ay hindi MEP, at sana to patuloy niyo pa rin akong suportahan. At kung meron kayong mga kilala ng mga engineers or mga staff o personnel na nagtatrabaho sa working in the construction industry, in the office, in the design drawing, using the rivet, you can recommend my channel so I can help by sharing my knowledge in MEP rivet. Okay guys, hanggang dito na lang po at maraming salamat po. Bye-bye! Mwah!